Hey YouTube, I hope everyone's doing okay out there, and I hope everyone had a happy Thanksgiving. So Egypt is in turmoil. The Muslim Brotherhood president, the Muslim Brotherhood president, I was about to say again, the president, Morsi, has decreed himself dictatorial powers. And everyone in the media that sold us this Arab Spring as a movement for democracy and to remove all these dictators, which, by the way, were propped up by the U.S. and the West, you know, they're selling us the idea now that, oh, we didn't know that the Muslim Brotherhood were going to do this. We're so surprised. You know, if the idiots in the media did their research and they understood what the Muslim Brotherhood was about, then they wouldn't have been saying all along that the Arab Spring was about democracy. What the real problem is that the dictators that have been overthrown so far weren't playing ball with the West and the U.S. So what happened? Well, someone, I'm not sure who, instigated these revolutions. And now, of course, the backlash of these revolutions, courtesy of the religion of peace, is that these new dictators are coming to power. A good prime example. Let's look at Egypt. Egypt now has a full-fledged dictator now. President Morsi of the Muslim Brotherhood has decreed himself dictatorial powers. Now, of course, Egyptians are rightfully so pissed off, and they're protesting. And what bothers me about this is that these are the individuals that voted this man into power. The Muslim Brotherhood has stated for many, many, many years what their ultimate goal is, and that is power, to obtain it. And I can't help but draw parallels between what's happening in Egypt versus Nazi Germany. Now let me explain. Hitler did not take Germany by force. Hitler did not roll into the German Reichstag with army tanks. It was a gradual process. First it started with newspaper articles, then it started with him making speeches, then it started him forming a party, then it started with the party gaining power, then little by little, you know, that party started making laws to say, hey, Jews gotta wear the Star of David. If you're a communist, you go to jail. If you're intellectual, liberal, or gypsy, you start to go to concentration camps, or not concentration camps, that's during World War II. But you get the idea of what happened. And the parallels of what's in terms of Egypt, you know, you can't help but read a history book and go, hey, what happened in Nazi Germany is happening here in Egypt. And it's very scary because it's a textbook type of scenario where the Muslim Brotherhood were just waiting in the shadows for their opportunity, and this is their opportunity. And Egyptians, like I said, are rightfully so pissed off, and they should be pissed off, because their own people died and struggled to get rid of one dictator. And now this guy comes along and says, hey guys, meet your new dictator. At the same time, the Egyptians voted this guy in. So why are they complaining? You know, they knew what the Muslim Brotherhood was all about. Didn't they know that this was going to happen? Didn't they know that this is what they stood for? Didn't they know that all along the Muslim Brotherhood was just waiting for the opportunity to gain power, then to take over? Didn't they know this already? I mean, it's like here in America. same exact thing. You know, we voted, unfortunately, for President Barack Obama for another 4 years. Now, of course, I didn't vote for the guy. I voted for someone else. No, it wasn't Romney. But I voted for someone else. And, you know, again, we get what we vote for. The Egyptians, guess what? You get what you voted for. Peace.